ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశర్షభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదన్స్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్ అండ్ మే ది ఆల్ మైటీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టూ ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పెరిటీ, గుడ్ హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ ఆల్ లక్ష్మి కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత ద చాప్టర్ నంబర్ 3 verse number 9. శ్రీ భగవాన్ వాచ యజ్ఞార్థాత్ కర్మణోన్యత్ర లోకోయం కర్మ బంధనః తదర్థం కర్మ కౌంతేయ ముక్త సంఘ సమాచర. సో వి హావ్ ఆల్రెడీ బిగన్ దిస్ వర్డ్స్ ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ సెషన్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్, బట్ దేర్ ఆర్ మీనింగ్ ఎట్ టు బి అండర్స్టూడ్. అయం లోక కర్మ బంధ. అయం లోక మీన్స్ వాట్? అయం లోక మీన్స్ దిస్ లోక, దిస్ వర్ల్డ్. వాట్ ది శాస్త్ర మీన్స్ దిస్ వర్ల్డ్? దిస్ వర్ల్డ్ మీన్స్ ద ఫస్ట్ మీనింగ్ బికమ్స్ దిస్ బాడీ. హౌ? బికాస్ వేర్ డూ వి ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ అవర్ సెల్ఫ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ దిస్. దాట్స్ వాట్ వీ కెన్ సే దిస్. వీ కెన్ నాట్ యూజ్ దాట్. దాట్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఫార్ ఫ్రమ్ యూ దాట్ డే. So that day may be passed according to the time and according to the space wise. Space wise if you make it is far from you, time wise if you make it may be in the past, that day. So in that day also can be referred in the future. Next month I am going to go to Kedarnath, Badrinath. That day, on that day, I am going to wear sweaters. That day, either it refers future or past, or it refers something which is not nearby. Here it is said, this lokaha means, first it becomes the sharira is our own lokaha. Then next is what? The nearby objects which is around us also means this lokaha. Then not only that, the loka from birth to death, whatever that we meet, we experience, everything is nothing but this lokaha. Because when anything comes near to you, that becomes this. So every that can become this. That's the secret. If Himalayan mountains are that now, if you go there, it becomes this. Whatever the object is very far from you, when you go reach to that object, it becomes this. And every that can be converted as a this. Therefore what? There is no that, this. According to our experience, the world which is experienced is called this lokaha. It includes present and past and future, three of them. These three of them, when we experience, that experience alone is called lokaha. First meaning I said, the body and object around us, and object which was there in the past and future and now, everything is called lokaha. But finally, everything is nothing but our experience. Experience is me. That me experiences what? Me and world, that is what is known as this lokaha. But in Gayatri, there are seven up, there are seven down lokaha are introduced. Bhuhu, bhuvaha, suvaha, mahaha, janaha, tapaha, satyam. Seven words towards up. And seven words towards down. Atala, vitala, sutala, rasatala, mahatala, talatala, patala. This lokaha, we cannot see. Can we get the ticket, flight tickets? I don't care how much the ticket is, but I want to go there. No, you cannot go there, because it is not time-wise, it is not space-wise. It is beyond time and space, because your body is limited by time and space. These lokas are not limited by time and space. It has got its own time. That time doesn't suit you. For example, this creature, a mosquito, has a very short period of time. A dog has got a 7 years whole lifetime, but you have 120 years. The time variation, it also depends according to our psychological system. The mind does the matter. It experiences the time. Therefore, I am lokaha means whatever is experienced in this body as an experience called lokaha. And especially this, according to Gayatri, this lokaha called Bhu Lokaha is the middle one. You can travel towards up, you can even travel towards down. Once you are initiated Gayatri, you never travel towards down, only towards up. Travel is being confirmed. The seat is being confirmed. That's what the glory of Gayatri. That's what the glory of all other mantras, not only Gayatri. All other mantras, if you got a guru, that itself fantastic. You will travel towards up, not towards down. Here we need to have Shraddha to believe, to take it further, because Shastra never lies. If you want to have evident, you can go and see Panchanga. Panchanga is a part of our Veda in which you can predict when this solar eclipse and the lunar eclipse will take place. Even after 100 years, exactly the day will be noted there. Therefore, Shastra, it has got its own capacity. It's beyond our eyes. What I cannot see, the Shastra can see. That Shastra says, this lokaha, Bhu lokaha, is karmachitan lokaha. It's waved by karma. Everything is karma. When you produce one karma, that one karma, one simple action, it has got connection with lots of karmas. You cannot have a separate action. That action, either it should be a continuation of the past actions. You cannot produce a new action. It's like a layer in the ocean. One layer pushes another layer, so it becomes ocean full of layers. So one layer is connected to all other layers because the current connects the layers. In the same way, you cannot produce a separate action. You are pushed, or you are driven by so many aspects. Therefore, what your action is not the separate one. That is the meaning. I am lokaha karma bandaha. The actions around you, it binds you. Every action has got the fruit, which we have already seen. Those fruit will bind you. Therefore, we have to be careful with our body, our mind. So only the solution is, all karmas which we saw in the last class, we have seen 5 categories of karma introduced in the Shastra. Nitya karma, Naimittika karma, Prayaschitta karma, Kamya karma and Nishiddha karma. Nishiddha karma has to be taken first. Nishiddha means that should be avoided. See, that karma which to be avoided, it has to be avoided first. Then Nitya karma. So Nishiddha karma, when you do, when you perform, you will get papa. That's what, you know, we can understand the sukshma, secret of these 5 karmas, which I was not able to complete in the last session. This Nitya karma, when you perform, you won't get punya, but when you are not performing, you will get papa. Naimittika karma also same. When you perform, you won't get punya, but if you miss, you will get papa. So the papa, that bad deeds which are achieved by not performing these 2 can be neutralized by prayaschitta. That's what prayaschitta. When you perform prayaschitta, you won't get punya. When you don't perform prayaschitta, you won't get. But you can neutralize the papa. The prayashchitta can neutralize papa. It won't bring new punya. In the same way, kamya karma means a desired action. The action for desired object to achieve, called kamya karma. When you perform kamya karma, this is the magic. You can earn punya and earn papa, both. If you drop kamya karma, you won't get punya or papa, but you cannot be there. Now, this is the secret of kamya karma. And this nishiddha karma, the karma to be avoided. If you avoid the karma, you won't get punya or papa. But if you perform it, you will definitely affected by papa. Do you understand? And you may not see that these all, you know, is the imagination. I don't care. If you say these five aspects are imagination, I don't care. I'm not pouring, pushing, compelling you to, you have to believe, then alone you can live the life. No. If you believe or not, you can live your life. But if you know the secret of, this is not final conclusion, what I tell you. This is somehow we can get a kind of understanding, okay, somehow, not completely. So that's lagbag. In Hindi we call it a lagbag. So, we cannot give complete definition. That's what karma sukshmam. Somehow Veda has given. Missing nitya karma, naimittika karma will bring papa. Performing these two won't bring punya. And prayaschitta, when you do perform this prayaschitta, you can neutralize papa which was earned by missing nitya karma, naimittika karma. And this kamya karma can be the tool. You can earn punya and you can earn papa. Then this nishiddha karma, so you can earn papa by performing these five sukshmas. Now we are not going to touch nitya karma. Okay, note carefully. We are not going to touch naimittika karma. We are not going to do modification about prayaschitta karma. Anyway, we are not going to perform this nishiddha karma. We are going to do only kamya karma. This is the only one tool. This kamya karma in which you can earn punya and you can earn papa. There, if you change your attitude, bhavana, as yajna bhavana, you can earn that which is beyond punya and papa. I tell you, beyond punya and papa. It means what? Chitta suddhi. That chitta suddhi as known as a chitta prasada. Prasada which will give a kind of qualifications for moksha. These secrets must be understood, accepted. Yajnyarthat karmano anyatra. Anyatra means only the karma. The actions must be performed with yajna bhavana, otherwise this kamya karma will become poison to you. Either it will give punya or papa, it won't give chitta shuddhi. So the beyond punya papa, we call it chitta shuddhi, chitta prasada. That's what our motto is. The yajna will modify our punya and papa, it will give more than punya and papa. We don't have rights to touch nitya, naimittika, prayaschitta and nishiddha karma. We have only rights to work with kamya karma. These divisions are pakka divisions. You need to dig more. In future, in fourth chapter also it will come. And yajna means what? That's what the questions which were where we stopped. The yajna means what? It is said here, the Bhagavan himself says, yajna means it is invented by Lord itself. Yajnas are apaurushayam, like Vedas are apaurushayam. And normally yajna means fire ritual. But the fourth chapter introduces more than this fire ritual. There are 12 kinds of yajnas. A sportsman, when he makes practice, he is digging with his body, mind and sense complex for a year, for 10 minutes. For example, if a person is athlete, so he is a running competition champion, he runs every day for that 2 minutes. He spends whole year practicing, keep practicing. That is also considered a kind of yajna. But that yajna categorized in different way in the fourth chapter. The mind becomes havan kund. That's a great invention by our Shastra. Gita talks about everything. Now, so every object when we define, we have to tell the manufacturing date and expiry date. Now its manufacturing date means when it was originated. Yajna means what? That's what given answer. Saha yajna praja srishtva purovacha prajapatihi anena prasavishyadvam yeshavostvishta kamadhuk. Prajapatihi saha yajna praja srishtva purovacha. Prajapatihi means a creator in the beginning when world was created. This is created like a story, you know. When we are not able to understand something, it has to be given as a story form. So it is created, you know, there was a creator that created the world. During the creation of the world itself, he created yajna, and the yajna and the world, prajaha means the beings were created and the yajnas also created. After created the yajna, the prajapati creator said, anena, by this you will be nourished. By this means what? By the yajna you will be nourished. This yajna is kamadhuku, like a kalpataru, kamadhenu. It will provide whatever that you ask. Now, yajna is for human being. Yajna is for all the being. Fire ritual, the any ritual which is called yajna, which is based on adrushta, is meant for being the welfare of auspicious of human being. That's the meaning comes. Anena prasavishyadvam. May you get nourished by this yajnas, because yajna will give whatever that you ask. This for example can be Putra Kameshti Yaga, which was performed by Dasharatha Chakravarti so that he could get Rama. And even Draupadi was got by the ritual alone. This ritual, there are Vajapeya Yaga, Vishwajit Yaga, Ashwamedha Yaga. These yajnas are huge yajnas. A king can do it. Otherwise, you know, small yagas like a homa, Ganapati homa, Navagraha homa, Purusha Sukta homa. So every homa, these are all systematic fire rituals. When you perform, definitely you will be provided the benefit. How these yajnas provide benefit, that's the secret. So we will continue the next verse. Verse number 11. Devan bhavayatan ena te deva bhavayantuvah parasparam bhavayantaha shreyah paramavapsyat. Now yajna is kind of a transaction between human being and devas. Devas means devata, deities. Yajna is an instrument to communicate with the deities. It's a pakka transaction. You offer something, you will gain something. That's the niyati of the world. The secret of the rule of the world is if you spend something, you will gain something. When you do exercise, you spend your sweating by doing dumbbells, you will get the benefit. Dumbbell won't get benefit. But nobody will ask that. So how can a dumbbell can give a strong muscles? If you go to a gym, you should know how to do. You need to have a coach. He will say, so which weapon, which the machine can be used first, and there is an order, that order he will instruct you. You need to have an instructor. In the same way, here also, yajna means you need to have hota, hotra visheshaha. A person, one has learned how to perform this yajna, because karma doesn't have option, no question at all. If a Ganapati Homa is done, Devata is Ganapati. And there are certain materials, dravyas, especially meant for Ganapati Homa. You need to have Modaka, you need to have certain other things. And every Homa is done with Ajya or Ghee. There is a specific place for Ghee. It may change according to the Homas. Chandi Homa is to have its own size of Homa Kunda. And that bricks also, it has to be given according to its own number. The Shira Bhaga, Kalasa Thapanam also. Kalasa is it's like a human body. It's a Kalasa is the Shiraha, head. And this Homakunda is like a stomach. In our stomach, if you ask a person to lie down, so head comes like this and this stomach comes here. The stomach is that Yaga Kunda where you offer your all materials, dravyas. In the form of havis, when you offer something, when you have food inside, all food are digested here. In the same way, when you give directly, first the shiras, the kalasa, the devata must be done prana pratishta. Then when you offer that, devata is receiving. That is the science of yajna. The science alone we are going to see in detail in forthcoming verses. Now here, yajna means on fire ritual. And also acharyas, they give one more ritual. There are five kinds of yajnas that has to be brought every day in our life. Nara Yajna, Pitru Yajna, Deva Yajna, Rishi Yajna, Bhuta Yajna. I will explain one by one. I am not in a hurry. First we will see what is proper Yajna. Yajna means what? It's a fire ritual. A fire ritual, how it has to be understood? A fire ritual is a transaction. Through you can get nourished, that transaction between devata means the deities, that appropriate deities especially meant for every Homa. So every Homa has got its own deity. Okay, that deity and you, that is a transaction. Bhagavan says, Devan Bhavayate. By this Homa or Yajna, you just bhavayata. He doesn't say that you perform yajna. He says bhavayata. You show your attitude. Showing attitude. How can I show the attitude? If you want to thank somebody, how will you show that thanking attitude towards him? You have to use some gesture. Can you say that thanks, sir? Okay, some people, you know, they say thank you, sir. Some people say, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. You do sometimes sashtanga namaskar. This showing attitude, we need to have some gesture. Through this yajna, you show the attitude means what? Yajna is the actions. The bhavana, it gets more predominant place than this action. The actions must be endowed with bhavana. Without bhavana, the action remains mere action. Fruit won't be achieved. Therefore, he said bhavayata. He doesn't say that you get it done. You just show your bhavana towards devata through yajna. They also show the bhavana. They will also nourish by showing their bhavana. Parasparam bhavayantaha. Both you may show the attitudes, share the attitude through the material, through the yajna actions, rituals. Then what? Both of you may get glorious things. Shreyaha parama avapsyata. You may get both nourished by this yajna. Bhavayata. Please show the attitude each other. That is the method which is to be understood in the beginning, which is said by Krishna itself. Then, Ishtan bhogan hi odevaha dasyante yajna bhavitaha tayadattana pradayebhyaha yo bhunte stena evasaha. Now, this yajna has performed. How the fruits are taking place. When you get that fruit, what kind of attitude we have to have with those fruit, that also said here. He doesn't say how the science works. That science, it is said verse number 14 and 15. There we will see the science of yajna. Now he says, so yajna is the tool through which you can transact with devatas, both you are nourished. So when you are benefited, when you are fructified with the fruit, you should not think that fruit is only for me. You should have the attitude, it's for all. If you think that only it's for me, you are considered like a thief. That's what he has said. Ishtan bhogan hi vo devaha dasyante yajna bhavitaha. So whatever you ask, those devatas, deities will provide you. So deities means Ganapati Homa has, Ganapati as a deity. And Durga Sukta Homa, Durga is a deity. Purusha Sukta Homa, Mahavishnu is the deity. Chandi Homa, Chandi is the deity. So like every Navagraha Homa, Navagrahas are the deity. Those deity will give whatever you ask. By performing yajna, they will definitely give. So, but when you are receiving that fruits, you should not be endowed with selfishness. You have to give it to the world. That's what the bhavana for all, not only for me. But if you think that it's only for me, you will be considered as a thief. Tena eva saha. That person will be considered as thief alone. We will stop here. We will continue next verse tomorrow in the next episode. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Om.